Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. I would like to begin today's story with a quote. Regrets are pointless, but history is a lengthy regret. Everything might have gone differently. Of course, God Almighty has written, and that is exactly what will occur. Then why am I sharing this quote? Because I kind of like it and that's why I'm sharing it. Anyways, the events of today's story occurred in Kuwait. It's about a good-natured investigator who was hardworking and a laid-back individual. So he was God-fearing and he was honest in his as an investigator because there are good and bad everywhere. So this man, when he returned home, he sat with his wife and he was laughing about something, or as I would put it, he was playing a joke. Perhaps it was something like, as you are aware of, a man may marry more than a wife or woman in Islam. The religion of Islam, that is. Now, let me explain how it works in more detail. So in Islam, marriage is, an institution with extremely vital goals. However, a man is permitted to marry more than wife under specific circumstances, which are subject to the condition that how he treats his women, and it should be in fairness, and he should make the choice of taqwa. People question why Islam permits polygamy, which I believe is a good concept, because if we read more or see the individuals who have spouses, we will discover that they have valid reasons. And it's not obligatory. I wouldn't say it's required to, we are not required to obey this regulation, men that is, but it can be, I would say, a reason of a woman cannot bear kids or has problems in her pregnancy or mentally or is not capable to fulfill the needs of a man. Here he can marry a second wife and there's nothing wrong with that. So he told her that I intend to marry again. Bring a second wife. So actually this was, again, his intention was that this was supposed to be a joke. In this instance, you may get envious. In fact, envy may be beneficial in some situation. And of course, jealousy is like salt in romance. A little may improve the flavor, but too much can ruin the experience. And in this, or in certain cases, be harmful. Anyways, she began weeping and shouting when he told her that he wanted to marry again. And he was actually, I would say, genuinely pleased with her response. Maybe because she mistook it for that would be real, that will happen. So they were sitting in the living room and she stood up and departed. He wanted to explain her that he was kidding, but she stood up and she walked down the hallway into the kitchen. She screamed and said, "That's it. I'm going to kill myself." It implies that there are other options, but she was enraged. What are the options? Other options would be that she had the option of losing control, and she did. She could have simply left the home or done something different to prevent any more issues. So what happened? He got out of the couch and walked over her to confess once again that he was kidding and he didn't intend to do so. Now she was clutching a knife. She really went to the kitchen to get a knife so that she could commit suicide. It all occurred so quickly that they accidentally drew close to each other while going through the door near the hallway that her husband's chest was pierced by the knife, which she was holding. The error was that it went straight, as did the knife, right into his heart. The lady had lost control and it was a dangerous situation. It was a near fatal twist of destiny. The guy collapsed on the floor and she was screaming. She didn't know what to do in this terror, and he was still breathing and vibrantly alive. She now considered saving her husband's life. So instead of shouting, she thought that taking out the knife out of his body would help or would be beneficial. That is what she believed. However, instead of saving him, the whole situation was that it began bleeding violently again and the blood was gushing out. So she had enough saving her husband's life. She couldn't do it. She couldn't see the situation. She just opened the door and exited the home and began running in an undetermined direction. She didn't know where to go. She wanted to get out of the whole situation and she didn't want to see the scene anymore. And the moment she was shouting, she was running away, she was actually holding a knife in her hand without knowing what she was doing. She fully lost her mind. After what had occurred or what she had witnessed, this is what she was going through. The most significant aspect of the tale is how everything is linked together. How every occurrence by now, when I'll tell you, is linked to the other. Now, the guy was still alive after she left home and he was pleading for assistance, but no one was listening. So he began crawling towards the door and he was screaming. He screamed once again. As previously said, the door was open, so he wished for anybody outside to hear him and come to his aid, or to at least call the ambulance. He couldn't go to the door since he was still bleeding severely. However, one of the neighbors saw his wife screaming and shouting outdoors. So he got closer to her, trying to figure out what was wrong with her. But he couldn't since she was running as quickly as she could. As a result, he walked to the other house door and discovered it open. When he walked in, he saw this guy lying in the hallway. He quickly phoned the emergency medical services and they came with paramedics to assist this individual. He was stunned to his scene and he sat alongside this guy in the ambulance. He provided him with the immediate treatment. The paramedic provided him with the immediate treatment he needed while ensuring that they arrived at the hospital promptly and securely. The man who was stabbed, or I would say mistakenly stabbed by his wife, told the paramedic in the ambulance that she didn't intend to stab me. It was an accident. He said he was kidding about something and it was his fault. Saying that his wife is innocent, he died before the ambulance could get to the hospital. Well, they transported the deceased corpse to the hospital, and after performing his work, he departed from the same location he came from when he received another call. Now, according to the unknown call or source, there was a lady in the same region. He said that it was a suicide attempt in which the lady attempted to slit her wrist, which she did, and it was bleeding. So when he returned, he escorted the lady to the ambulance and they headed back to the hospital. He implored her to calm down, but she was still in panic and in a frenzy state of mind. She had no idea what she was doing. After all, she had slain her own husband and the father of her children. So she found it difficult to believe. How could she have done such a thing? Even if it was by accident. While telling her to calm down, he replied, "Don't worry, because the cut isn't that deep. You'll be fine." But despite the fact he was saying, he was shocked at how much she was bleeding. And then she started pleading and she was saying that, "Please save him." The man here realized that she was asking him to save someone. This someone was none other than the man who had just died in the ambulance. So there was a link, and this was the link between these two. In this instance, he responded, "Don't be concerned or don't worry, he'll be all right." He had been rushed to the hospital and he had been hospitalized. And she was also hospitalized and transported immediately to surgery after arriving to the hospital. And once she recovered, they told her that her husband had died, and she was virtually insane, or she had lost her mind. She couldn't understand that just because he made a joke didn't mean that an entire family should have been lost or destroyed. As I previously said, she had no intention of doing so. It was just a mistake that shouldn't have occurred, but yet again, the police hauled her in for investigation and questioning. And the matter was brought to court along with the man or the paramedic who was in the car, given that he had heard from the man himself in the ambulance, and he was one of the witnesses proving that the man himself before dying said that his wife was innocent and it wasn't her fault. Of course, she was not executed. I would say condemned to life imprisonment. But the lesson here was that patience is important, as it is not judging too fast. And there are times when we think things might have been different. But if things have to happen, only God Almighty can stop them. And I would like to conclude that in every situation, in any criminal case, the conclusion is the same. It's remorse. It's regret. That's all for today, and thank you for your time.